Just lift your hands and begin to worship this God, because His God will respond like unto Him. The Word of God is always a and amen. He's our God from beginning to the end. Just exalt Him, magnify His only name. As we gather, may Your Spirit dwell within us. As we gather, may we glorify Your name. Knowing well that as our heart begins to worship, we be blessed because we came.
For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Luke chapter 24, I read verse 2. He said, but they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. Their joy was that the stone was rolled away. And when they went in, they realized that the body of Jesus Christ was not there anymore. That is the joy of resurrection. That is the power we have as Christians. If Christ has not risen, you and I would have made a caricature of our Christianity. But the devil has failed. And because he has failed, concerning your life and your marriage, your business, all that concerns you, it will remain a failure in the name of Jesus. It will remain a failure in the name of Jesus. So whatever stone that the enemy has rolled into your life and is causing you delay, pain, affliction, and sorrow, after this ministration, those stones shall be rolled away. They shall be rolled away. They shall be rolled away. In the name of Jesus. In Joseph chapter 9, we were told from verse 1 that now as Jesus passed by, he saw a man who was blind from birth. And the disciples asked him, saying, Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, very interesting answer, neither did this man nor his parents sin, but that the work of God should be revealed in his life. Amen, somebody. The glory of God must be revealed in your life. It must be revealed in your family. It must be revealed in your marriage. There was a stone that was placed in the life of that man. That was the stone of blindness. But the Bible said that before the world began, God had orchestrated the glory of his presence to locate that man. And when the time came, the man received his sight. I stand here this morning and I pray for somebody. Wherever the enemy has taken your glory to, you shall recover it. I said you shall recover it. You shall recover it. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift up the cup with me. Oh Lord, my Father. Oh Lord, my Father. Every glory hijack us. Every glory hijack us. Locating my family. Scattered by fire now. Begin to pray this morning. Every glory hijack us. Designed to locate my family. Scattered by fire. You glory hijack us. You glory afflict us. Locating my family. Scattered by fire. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Be now exalted. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lord, we thank you because your word is there and amen. Give you all the glory because you have the absolute power. As we share in your word, let your word bring life. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Let us have our seats. Once again, in the name of God, we welcome you to your Father's house. And it is a prayer that you listen to the word of God. His word shall bring life into our lives. In the name of Jesus. Whatever platform you're watching us right now, we pray that God will touch you mightily. In the name of Jesus. It is evident that the stone was rolled away. One of the signs of the mighty work of God is that when it was time for Jesus to return back to the Father, the stone was not there anymore. The enterprise of the enemy to hinder the power of God was in futility. That is why we are confident this morning that our joy must locate us. Our peace must locate us in the name of Jesus. The power of transformation, the transformative power of the Lord. We saw in John chapter 9 about a man who had an encounter with Jesus, and the disciples said to Jesus, Jesus, who is responsible? This man who has been born blind, is it his parents or even the boy himself? Jesus Christ said, this man is not responsible, neither is his parents, but that the glory of God will be made manifest in your life. I tell somebody here this morning, that power, that glory, and his long awaiting your destiny will visit you in the name of Jesus. So we find that John chapter 9 gives us a clear picture of a man whose life was an object of ridicule. A man whose life was not worth attracting. A man whose life was less admirable. A man who was born blind. A man who has no definition as to what was responsible for his condition. When Jesus had an encounter with this man, hearing that and clear, three things happened to him. Number one, there was a divine release. Amen, somebody. Under the sound of my voice this morning, every embargo, every load, enemy that have been released into your life to cause pain and affliction, those embargoes, those load shall catch fire in the name of Jesus. So what did Jesus release into the life of this man? He released sight. I don't know if you have been blind, whether physical or spiritual. After this encounter, the power that brought back Jesus will give you sight. In that business, you will receive your sight. In that mind, you will receive your sight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Number two, there was a divine identification. Amen, somebody. From Christ's discussion with the disciples, it was evident that the case of this man was already long settled in heaven. There was an identification that this man someday, sometime, there will be a divine visitation. I don't know what God has proposed for you. I don't know what is the plan of God for your life. One thing I know for sure is that those who serve the Lord, God has a purpose for their life. God has a plan for their life. And whether they don't like it or not, that plan of God for your life will come to pass. In the name of Jesus. In the midst of ups and downs, in the midst of hardship, I see God working out His purpose in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. The power of God was made manifest. That was why we encountered a divine identification and fulfillment. The word of God came to pass in that man's life, and that was what brought about his restoration of his sight. I pray for somebody here this morning, you will receive your benediction. You will receive your testimony. You will receive your glory. You will receive your joy. If I'm speaking to you, let your amen be the loudest this morning. Number three. One, we were told that there was a release. And two, there was a divine identification. And three, the glory that was designed for that man did not pass him by. That was that on that fateful day, Jesus Christ said that neither the father, the parent, nor the boy will sing, but that the glory of God to be made manifest. Hence, that glory located the man. Wherever the enemy has kept you, they kept Christ in the tomb, but the power of God located Jesus. If that same power is still on the throne, it will locate you for your testimony. It will locate you for your miracle in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your hand this morning and just begin to say a word of prayer to the kingdom. And say, Father, let your word of transformation, let your word of healing, let your word of restoration locate me as never before. Libra koriba keta neko baradash, lezu korima rita sakikara, le karasita rika leta terbo. Let your word locate me this morning as never before. Let your word locate me, let your word locate me, let your word locate me, let your word locate me in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Be thou exalted, be thou glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Beloved Christ, not every encounter is transformative. Because today we talk about the power of transformation. Not every encounter is transformative. But your encounter shall be transformative. Not every encounter brings results. Your encounter will bring multiple results. In the name of Jesus. Paul had an encounter and it was transformative. The man at the pool of Bethesda had an encounter and it was transformative. The scripture accounts in Exodus chapter 34 verse 29 that when Moses had an encounter with God at the tent of meeting, three things happened. His face became radiant. There was a transformation. Number two, he became a subject that mattered in the camp. And three, he became a product of the glory of God. Hear me loud and clear. As an oracle of El Agado, I prophesy to somebody's life hearing me right here and now. Surely as the Lord liveth, you shall be radiant all around this month and beyond. Your finances will experience radiancy. No infection, no affliction will locate your territory. And whether the enemy like it or not, you are the next in line to be visited. Your glory will be manifested. Your joy shall be complete. When others are casting down, you shall be lifted up. When others are seen dead, you shall be seen breakthrough. If you believe right up on your feet and with your head and going to worship this God, from beginning to the end, there's no place for argument. Sing you are God.